It's being labelled a bonk ban, and today Australian tourists in Bali were reacting to a new Indonesian law which threatens a year's jail for anyone caught having sex outside of marriage. It's among a raft of new conservative rules imposed by Indonesia in the lead-up to next year's election. Experts say there's no exception for international visitors, but there is one important catch.
It's Australia's favourite island getaway, known for its beaches, Bintang, and now a bonk ban.
Bali will lose a lot of tourists. I will stop coming here. I won't risk a jail sentence for a year, a little holiday.
You should be able to jiggy-jig whoever you want.
Indonesia's parliament has ratified a new criminal code punishing sex outside of marriage with up to a year in jail.
The Indonesian government has said that it's going to phase it in over 3 years. It's not clear what that means.
It's going to make people second guess a little bit coming over here.
You're your own country, you can do whatever you want.
Tourism is the lifeblood of Bali's economy. 18 plane loads of Aussies fly to the island every day.
Probably going to be in a bit of trouble. I'm not married and I'm single, so I don't know how that's going to work out for me.
Their country, they can do whatever they like.
You live your way, abide by your rules in your land, you've got to abide by the rules in someone else's land.
Experts say the new law has some important fine print. Police can only investigate if they get a complaint.
Oh, it does require a report from a close member of the family, a husband, a wife, or a parent or child.
It sparked demonstrations. The new laws also criminalise cohabitation outside marriage. They punish abortion and make it illegal to insult public officials.
I don't think this law is about tourism. I think it's about politicians positioning themselves as moral champions in the lead up to major elections.
Still, there are no exceptions for international visitors.
I can understand that this has been, a source of some anxiety.
But even late this afternoon, the Foreign Affairs Smart Traveller website still hadn't been updated to warn Australian tourists. Daniel Sutton for 10 News First.
And we asked you on social media if you travelled to Bali after the ban was announced. Only 27% of people said yes, 73% said no.